I'm going to tell you right now, get used to this screen. You're going to see it a lot. Derubim says, what could possibly go wrong with Sonic? Oh, God. Don't even get me started. So this is the infamous Sonic the Hedgehog 2006. This is the PlayStation and 3 version, which I picked up recently because I saw... Actually, Slow Beef, the LPer, he did a stream of it. And I saw it and I said, it actually looks kind of... I got to try this for myself. And I tried it, and the thing is, it's as bad as they said, and you know, I'm going to share all the reasons why, but at the same time, I found it weirdly compelling. Like, I've been playing through the whole damn thing. So actually, I'll let the opening video play. So this is it. I'm just going to run through this. This isn't going to, I'm going to play it as long as I can. I have actually been playing through it. This isn't a blind run. Just, I wanted to make sure that it was playable enough that I could get through it without repeating the same sections over and over again, because that gets dull in the stream. So, let's just jump in and we'll discover the problems as we... And actually, already, right off the bat, one of the first problems is you can only have one save file. So I actually had to delete my save file completely that was two-thirds of the way through the game just so that I could restart it and play it again. We're gonna call that an interesting design decision. Yeah, these are the only real options you get, which it drives me crazy. There's no camera control options. So, like, I usually invert the controls. It took me a long time to get used to the camera controls, which, by the way, suck. I'm just going to say that right now. Another thing, just to warn you ahead of time, you... Oh, shit, I'm sorry, guys. I accidentally put in Final Fantasy XIV here. Right, go ahead. Look at this game right now. And if you had to guess what game this was, would you say Sonic the Hedgehog? And now here to open the Venetian Olympic Games. I guess I should be quiet and not ruin the story here. Hey, Tony Shalhoub is here! Welcome back, the Shoub.
Miss Elise? It's all right.
Yeah, no, you wouldn't want to tell anybody about that vision.
We give thanks for the blessed flames. May we always continue to have peace. Son of Soliana, guide and watch over us with your eternal light.
I would like to point out they are having the festival of the Son of Soliana in the middle of the night. Diceapp says, is it possible to ruin the story? The story, like, is the best part of this, honestly. It's so bad. Mystic says, was that thing Knuckles? Remember when he just used to turn, like, forest animals into cartoon robots? Now he just, like, nuked Venice.
And to take the miracle gems that are the key to its secret, the Chaos Emerald. Now, Princess, this way, please.
Wow, that's a pretty snazzy performance there.
Hmm? It can't
I like that he stopped to introduce himself. Because at this point, it is important to remind people what game they're playing. Demistic says, I thought you were serious that this was Final Fantasy XIV. Now pay careful attention, because this all will become sort of clear eventually. I hope. I've played 2/3 of the way through this game, and I have no idea what the fuck is happening in it. I'm just gonna throw that out there.
Why are you helping me?
No special reason.
Character motivation 101, people. Hey, O-Dog. Dodgepong says take a drink every time you see a loading screen. Spoiler alert.
Sonic, take this!
I've got it!
Gygax Magazine says that was amazing dialogue. Oh, hey, Gygax Magazine. Thanks for joining us.
It's only a matter of time before it's mine. Until then, you can hold on to it for me.
Darn it, he's getting away! If only I had some very specific talent for chasing after him! But he's moving at a slow, ambling pace. I could never catch up. And now we have our first quest of the game. Gather information about Dr. Eggman. And loading. So that is the opening to Sonic 2006.
What's Eggman up to? I need to gather some information.
And it's now daytime, so Sonic actually hung out all night contemplating what to do before he finally said to himself, hey, let's go and figure out what Eggman is up to. Okay, so these are the town scenes. If you notice any slowdown, by the way, that's not the stream. The game has a terrible slowdown problem.
If you see a mark above the head of someone in town, try talking to them.
Dodgepong says, I really don't get this. Eggman wanted the Chaos Emerald, so he kidnaps the princess who owns it. Eggman watches the princess throw the emerald to Sonic and is like, whatever, you can have it for now. Actually, that's one of the few plot points that is explained later. So I'm gonna leave that. So, like you expect from all good Sonic gameplay, you can wander around town and talk to the inhabitants. The yellow exclamation points indicate people who have nothing useful to say. And the orange ones indicate people who will point you along the way on your plot. Some other interesting stuff. The game actually does run at 60 FPS. When it's not suffering massive slowdown, which you will notice. Now, this is the other thing.
Sonic! Tails! Long time no see.
Every cutscene, it has a loading time. And every time it comes out of a cutscene, it has a loading screen.
You're going to rescue her, aren't you? Let me help! I may not know what Eggman's up to, but it can't be a good thing.
Okay, with your help, this should be a piece of cake.
I'll do my best.
It sure is a good thing we had the the multiple loading screens for that. Domestics like, why is no one like, what the hell is a talking hedgehog doing in the middle of a town? Yeah. See, apparently that's the thing. Like, there's like this weird, like, nobody in the town knows Sonic, but nobody thinks it's odd that there are all these anthropomorphic animals just running around. Like, if you talk to some of the people around, they were like, oh, Tails was just helping us rebuild after the festival.
Sonic, there's a nice store in this town. It might help you find a way to cross the sea.
Now, that is the way to the first level, but I can't get there yet. I actually need to buy an item. Whoops. So we're gonna do the first couple of quests here. I don't even know how to begin presenting this game, to be totally honest.
You can shop in town. Go to the stores off.
Okay, so the blue exclamation points are people who will give you missions. And this is actually a required mission. Most of the missions in town are optional. Each one of them has up to 4 loading screens around them. Which is why I don't do them. But this one is actually required. You have to get a pair of special shoes. And in order to do that, you basically have to do a movement tutorial. Okay, you can't... Yeah, no, this is quest-based hub gameplay. What were you expecting from a Sonic game? Sonic the Hedgehog MMO in 2016, says O-Dog. Okay, so now we get a loading screen, and then he says one more line, and then we get a loading screen again. At some point when things slow down, there's a reason why the game came out this way, and I actually looked into a lot of the development and stuff, and I'll bring it up. But for right now, you have this timed mission where you have to prove that you can basically move. Simply by running through. Whoops. Missed one. And those are the... That sort of, like, freak out at the end where he just, like, spun around in the air. He does that automatically. I don't know why. But, so the custom shoes thing, the idea is that with these shoes, you can stick different gems and chips into them and customize Sonic's abilities. And they were actually going to have this whole RPG element thing in the game where you could purchase certain abilities and equip them. And use them to kind of change Sonic's gameplay style.
That was incredible.
But in the end, they ended up cutting it, so only a few abilities ended up in the game, and most of them are required to proceed. O-Dog says it's a crafting system. It's not really. It was an experience system. The more you used an item, an ability, the more powerful it became. You can also see that at the end of each level, you are ranked based on your score, and that rank gives you rings that you can use as currency. And then that's what we use to actually buy, what we use to buy abilities. Then we can go to this store here.
Hey.
And we can buy our first ability, the light chip, which allows us to use the light dash. Whoops. Okay, so I guess a little bit about Sonic's abilities as I move toward the first stage. So obviously Sonic can move and jump. His primary attack is this homing attack, where if you point it toward the enemy, you can bounce off of him and do damage. And he's also got this dash kick, or this kick. Okay, that is a silver medal.
This is a silver medal.
There are a total of 10 of them in each stage, plus like 30 scattered around the city. If you collect them all, you get absolutely nothing because there's no trophy support in this game. But except for the satisfaction of knowing that you did it. The light dash allows you to slide along, whoops, when it works, allows you to slide, shit, okay. Okay, so that was the light dash, which allows you to slide through a row of rings, and then if you get lucky, you land where you're supposed to and not get flung off into the ocean. If you get unlucky, it just flings you off into the ocean. That time it worked, though you can hear Tails didn't quite make it, and he went to his screaming death. You'll get used to that. There's a lot of parts of this game that just don't work. And then this mirror takes us into the first actual stage of the game. The Wave Ocean, where we have to pursue Dr. Eggman's... You know what? The last time I played Sonic, apart from playing this game, it was Sonic 3, the one with Knuckles. So that's my entire experience with Sonic. There's been a lot of canon that got added since then, and now Eggman is Robotnik, and according to the comics, Robotnik and Eggman are like... if it looks like I'm having trouble steering, that's because the camera doesn't want me going off to the side. So this is an action stage now, and that's actually a checkpoint where you will come back when you die. This shows the homing attack. Oh, I guess the other guy just died. Okay. And these are dash blocks that will launch you through rings and other stuff like that. Shit. I got hung up on the terrain and died. More often than not, the dash pads will kill you if you don't use them exactly right. I hit it and tripped. Now I could just walk around up here like so. Oh, and then I just speed up. So that's how you use the dash pads. You can also homing attack into bumpers and stuff. This game is kind of a rail platformer sort of a thing, but not really, because there's multiple paths through the game. Like, for example, that where I jumped off the path through that little ring and used the ring dash, and Sonic's dash kick there just didn't go off, but that's fine. Now it did. So there's a couple of like branching paths. If you get hit with machine guns, So I clipped the ceiling there and fell, but that was actually a pretty good run. Is there any point in even trying to describe this? I mean, really. Like, I realize that probably looks like I can't play a video game, but I gotta say, at least half of it isn't me. And suddenly, Killer Whale. So Sonic didn't die from the water that time, which is good. And in this area, you're just better off not touching any buttons. Sonic just kind of does it on his own. But, oh, shit. Except I missed the sort of quick time event there. Okay, so... So there's quick time events where Sonic will launch himself into surfaces. There was one a little bit earlier on. He didn't make it to the dash pad on his own. That's okay. So, and then you have a limited amount of time to hit the X button to jump. And then Sonic grabs the whale. Because, sure.
Tails, go ahead and push the gate switch so he doesn't get out.
And now Tails. Okay, this is another one of the gimmicks, is that you change to other characters periodically through the game, like Tails. Tails can fly using his twin tails, and if he hangs out in the air too long, he'll tire out. Some of the difficulty of controlling Tails comes from the fact that the camera insists on pointing up at him, and as he flies, he automatically has forward momentum. There's... Oh, sometimes that ring will just launch you into the whale for... That's actually a new one. That didn't happen to me before. So as Tails flies, he always has forward momentum, but the camera is pointing up, so you can't see what's under him. And considering falling in the water will kill you, that adds a degree of challenge to the game. O-Dog is saying, what is Tails? Tails is a two-tailed fox that can fly with his tails, obviously.
Okay, Sonic, I'll be right back.
Okay. So Tails can fly. And see, like I said, it's hard to see what's under Tails, and the camera moves a little bit fast. So you tend to just sort of, like, freak out at the end. The only way to slow down is to spin yourself, basically, so that you don't fall off the edge. Tails' other ability is to throw these explosive bombs filled with rings. Which scatter these fake rings around that you can't pick up. And if you drop all your rings, that you get them confused for your real rings and then get killed. So again, it adds a level of challenge to the game. The game also auto-aims for you because there's no real way to aim other than vaguely pointing your controller in the direction of what you want to attack and then praying. Okay, fortunately I landed on the thing there. And the point of this is to find a button that lets me continue on the adventure. It's something to do with a gate that will keep the... Oh, that's right. So Tails also has this sniping ability, where if you hold down the button, you will go into first-person mode for one attack, and then the camera will automatically spin around and confuse the hell out of you, even if you try to stay in first-person mode. And usually you get hit. Also, because I can't invert the aiming controls, I tend not to use it. I think this is... Yeah, okay. Well, okay, so Tails flipped out a little bit. If you drop bombs in midair, you'll drop them sort of down below you. Ilion for Life is pointing out that Tails' original name is Miles Prower, yeah, as in miles per hour. I actually never picked up on that pun. And then we get to continue the stage. Oh, this is what is called, I think, am I going into the mock speed section? Yeah. So this is called the mock speed section. Periodically throughout the game, in order to make it more difficult, Sonic will decide that he has to move extra fast. And at that point, if you hit any obstacles at all, you will get damaged or die if you have no rings. And the animation is absolutely hilarious because Sonic... okay, I'm just kind of stuck there. So that's what happens when you die. Sonic just loses all his forward momentum and goes spinning off into the distance. The mock speed sections really rely more on memorization than anything. Actually, to be fair, this game is a lot like Dark Souls. Okay, in that, it relies on you learning and memorizing and just figuring out how to overcome the different challenges. Except the challenges in this game are the... Oops, I shouldn't have jumped for that. Okay. Except the challenges in this game are, mainly glitches and your abilities not working. And I kind of missed the ramp there. Okay, that's fine. It's fine. It's all good. We can do this. And honestly, once you sort of learn where the game's glitches are, you can... I don't want to say get good at it, because there's still just the element of random chance where, the game will just murder you outright. But you can sort of have more successes than failures. I don't jump for the items. I'm not trying to collect anything, because basically those things are trying to trick you into murdering yourself. I actually made it up the little secret ramp there. For whatever reason, Sonic actually just veers away from that ramp. Oh, shit. Okay. Alright, And that's actually a really interesting ramp that... Oh, okay, it didn't quite make the jump. Okay, no, that's fine. So those loop-de-loops are kind of automatic in that... Oh, shit, I missed the dash pad again. Okay.
Darn, we're not gonna make it! Let's speed up!
One life left. So those ramps and those other sections where Sonic is running up walls and stuff are fairly automated. The trick is that the game wants to bring you there, and as long as you don't hit any buttons, you won't fuck up the game too bad. It'll still occasionally fuck up and just launch you into a death pit or something. The key is to hit them exactly where the game expects you to be. Because they seem to be automated in that they deliver controls to Sonic. So for example, and I maybe I can show this off, I don't know. But with that last ramp there. Oh, shit. I just lost the stream, didn't I? Uh-oh.